recently, I thought that fluorescent light fixtures were very similar to other light fixtures, and all you had to do was change the bulbs every once in a while. And I could not have been more wrong. I've been having a problem with this light fixture here in my garage for months now. When I flipped the switch, it would either glow a little bit at one end and never fully light up, or it would flicker a lot, the flare is coming, or be so dim that it wasn't even really worth it. And changing the bulbs made no difference whatsoever. Unlike regular light bulbs, fluorescent bulbs operate based on the excitement of the molecules inside the bulb, and you have to have something to start that off with. And one day in a discussion on the Chick Fix group page, a lady said, oh, well, you know, when you change the fluorescent bulbs, you should also change the starter. A starter like on a car? Yes, a starter like on a car.
Ooh.
So I started off by trying to change the starter. I honestly have no idea how to do this, but I'm gonna figure it out. Now, where does this guy go? Maybe it's inside this thing. Okay.
What do I do?
It turns out that most modern fluorescent light fixtures don't actually have starters. They're what's known as rapid start, and they don't require a starter. If when you turn the light on, if there's a delay of a couple of seconds, then you probably have a starter. If it comes on pretty much instantaneously, you don't. Now, one thing that can happen with these is minerals can build up on the ends of these little connections and also on the actual fixture itself. These actually seem like they're okay, so I don't think that's the problem. Now, through a little bit of research, I decided that the issue is probably the ballast, which I'm gonna change. And frankly, I'm not real psyched about it because I don't like working over my head on a ladder, and there's an awful lot of wires up there. Now, there are some countries in this world where you are not legally allowed to actually change this out or do any kind of electrical work unless you're a licensed electrician. In the United States, you're fine, but countries like Australia, New Zealand, and I believe also Canada, you actually have to be a licensed electrician to do anything electrical at all. So keep that in mind and make sure you know whether or not you're legally allowed to do this. Now, there are different ballasts go with different types of fluorescent lights, so make sure that you're getting the right one. And it may also not even be the same size and shape of the one that's currently in there. You gotta go based on the wattage of the fluorescent lights, how many bulbs are in it, etc. If it's a two bulb, you're gonna have one of these. If it's a four bulb, you're probably gonna have two of these. Now, I'm noticing here that this new ballast has the same wires. It's got two red, two blue, two yellow, a black and a white. The only thing I'm worried about here is that the yellow actually on the new ballast comes out this direction instead of that direction. So I don't know if that's gonna be too much of an issue, but we'll see. I have already turned off the power to this garage, so I know that the power is unhooked. Make sure you do that before you do anything. I think I'll take those wires out first. We're just gonna have to see. Just kidding. The power is definitely off on these. I don't really like doing this. I don't like cutting wires. It scares me. What's the worst that could happen, right? It's already not working, so. This one up here has some electrical caps on it, and I probably didn't have to clip those. I probably could have just pulled them right out, but trying to follow the directions. All right. There we go. All right, it's out. Now the next thing I need to do is strip these wires about a half an inch. Unfortunately, I don't have any wire strippers, which seems like a really weird thing. I need to get some of those. So basically I'm just gonna do this very, very carefully, kind of score it. Ah, there we go, see? Those, I'll just take off that. Ah, there we go, did it. Now the fun part begins. Oh my gosh, look at me. Oh, look like a drowned rat. Oh, oh well, that's reality. Ow. I was kind of worried about whether or not it mattered which blue wire went to which blue wire on the ballast, but it basically just says connect them all. So I don't know, I'm gonna give it a shot and see. These electrical caps you can buy at any home improvement store. I think the yellow ones are gonna be big enough. And they will both keep the electrical connections attached to each other, but they'll also insulate them. My garage doors face the south, so we get the southern exposure, so this garage Feels like it's about 150 degrees right now.
I'm melting!
It always seems kind of strange to me that these electrical connections are this simple, like you're literally just attaching two wires together, but that is actually the way it is. Now, if you're an electrician watching and you're looking at this going, oh my God, that woman is going to burn her house down, I really would appreciate the constructive criticism below, keyword constructive, because I am still learning all of this stuff and I really don't want my family to get hurt or my house to burn down. Now, before I put all the casing back on this thing, I am gonna just stick a bulb in here and see if it works before I bother. Ah, it worked! Can you see that? It's actually working. That's awesome. Okay, I gotta go back down and turn the power back off. All right, well, let's see. Oh, I think I need to take that bulb out, actually. Oh yeah, I do. This thing just kind of squeezes into these little slots, so that's nice. Oh, jeez. That would not have been good. That would have shattered into a million pieces. Ugh. It gets worse and worse. Back down to the basement again. Turn the power back on. All right, here we go. Awesome. And now it is definitely time for me to go get a shower. Hair went off. At least I hope it's hair. Oh. That box of electrical caps fell off the ladder and went everywhere. Crap. Too many wires.